Yeah, sure. Russell, hi, how are you doing?
Hi, good, thanks, Jamie. How are you?
Yeah, not too bad. Negative, so it's a reason for celebration. Just a reaction, Russell, to the you know, the behind closed doors move by the Welsh government. What do you think?
I'm sad about it for our supporters. I'm obviously frustrated for our supporters. I'm just sad in general, I guess, at the way the world's been for the last 2 years. How not normal it is, but it's becoming normal. Lockdowns and restrictions. When been told, you know, it's one jab to freedom, two jabs to freedom, they need a booster. We can't have fans, but they can travel to the away game on Boxing Day. Just sad and frustrated by it. I think it feels the same as a lot of people by the whole saga. And the people that will be missing out, I'm really, really sad for them. And but I guess that's where we're at the moment, and we will have to deal with it and get on with it.
Yeah, I mean, as you say, it's slightly bizarre, isn't it, that you can go to Millwall with fans on Boxing Day and potentially Huddersfield and Hull in January, but yet your fans can't come and see you play Luton, Fulham and Southampton. I mean, it's bizarre, isn't it?
Yeah, it's, as I just said, it's not normal, but I can't really say too much, can I? But it's, I don't know. There's so much contradiction in rules. There's so much change. I don't know. We have to look at the science, and we have to look at what people are predicting. But there's just so much misinformation out there. So much information. You don't know what is misinformation, what's not. But fear, whatever we want to say about it, how dangerous it is, how infectious it is, fear is, it's been such a huge factor in everyone's life for 2 years, and it's deciding on so much now. So it is what it is. As I said, we have to accept it. I'm sad for the people that it affects. I'm really disappointed on a personal level for us that we're not going to have supporters in. And the fact that we can go to London on Saturday, where I'm pretty sure there's a load more cases than there are where we're based, and we can take a lot of supporters there. Doesn't make a huge amount of sense, but as I said, it is what it is, and we get on with it. We'll prepare for the game, and we look forward to having our supporters back in whenever we are told we're allowed to do so.
What's the COVID situation right now at Swansea, Russell?
We've had no one's symptomatic. We started testing every day because we have to. And we have a couple of positives. Again, like I said, the guys both have been vaccinated, both have got no symptoms, so they'll follow the isolation rules, which I think changed again yesterday, or maybe haven't here, I don't know, I'll get lost, but the doctor's well aware of it and what happens. So we're without a couple of players, everyone tested today, they're all negative, which is good news, so hopefully it will stay that way.
As you say, you're going to Millwall on Boxing Day. Steve Kavanagh is saying that if the game goes behind closed doors again, it's financial Armageddon. And there's also an issue, isn't there, about the integrity of games. If certain clubs in the Championship can play with fans and some, like yourselves, can't play with home fans at all, what do you think?
Yeah, of course, we're at a disadvantage. We can't play in front of ours. We're at a disadvantage financially. It affects what we're doing in January. It affects what we're doing moving forward because the uncertainty as well. There's no, we've been told it's for the next three games. After that, who knows? Who knows what's going to happen? But also, it's not me saying that Millwall shouldn't have any fans. It's crippling for so many industries. Hospitality industry in particular at the moment is taking a huge bashing with not a huge amount of science behind it, is what I read and the information I get. So our fans can't come to our game, but they can watch it indoors together. I don't know what the rules are. I'm getting lost. But it's financially, it's going to be difficult for a lot of clubs. I presume a lot of clubs have planned just in case this was going to happen again. It's really, really difficult, of course it is. But there's a lot of, not just football, not just sport, there's a lot of industries being really, really affected at the moment. And it's a really tough time. And hopefully we can get through this short period. Hopefully it is a short period and we can all get back to some form of normality at some point. And then that normality resumes.
And just finally from me, Russell, Mark Drakeford's been speaking this lunchtime about the issue not being fans at grounds, but how fans get to the grounds, how they go home, how people act in hospitality around them. And he says these are risks that we do not need to run. What's your reaction to those comments?
yeah, I can't have any reaction. We have to comply, and we have to listen, and we have to do what we're told if that's what the science suggests, and we have to stick with that. We don't have any other choice. It's that simple. It was vaccine passports were supposed to make a big difference, and now it's changed again. So we'll have to wait and see what the next change is. Hopefully it'll be a positive one when it comes.
Russell, thanks so much. Good luck. Cheers.
No problem.
Hi, Russell.
Hi, guys. Okay.
Yeah, good. Thanks. I'm not sure I've seen you look this downbeat the whole time you've been in charge at Swansea. You're frustrated with everything that's going on by the look of it.
Yeah, I think everyone's a bit tired by it, isn't it? I'm tired of talking about it, tired about arguing about it. I think the whole issue has been so politicised throughout the whole thing, and it becomes more and more politicised as we go on. So I want to be on here talking about my players and talking about our team and talking about the plans for January, which I'm sure you want to be talking about. Again, your job is brought back to this issue. Every area of life is brought back to this issue at the minute. So yeah, I'm tired of it, I'll be honest. I'm pretty sure a lot of people feel the same way. I apologise if I haven't got as much energy as I usually have, but not a particularly fun thing to talk about. So that's where we're at, unfortunately.
How difficult is it? I mean, how much of your time is now devoted to COVID-related planning and testing and all that sort of thing?
We're back to testing every day. We're back to not having meetings with the full team and everyone wearing masks and all that stuff, unless on a training pitch. This game is about connection. It's about relationships. It's about being able to see people's emotions and feel it and all of that. Becomes much more difficult when we have to adhere to the protocols. And I understand we have to stick to them, and we're doing that. It's not a pity party. We're not feeling sorry for ourselves. We just have to do it. But yeah, it takes a lot of energy. And it takes I think it distracts a lot of energy where you want to focus it on, and takes away because you have to spend so much time either discussing this or being concerned about it or making sure we're sticking to this and that. And something that the club do brilliantly is making sure that we're all as safe and following the protocols as closely as we possibly can. We have to do that now again for a period of time until we can get back to normality. And in the meantime, what is energising us is how hard the players have worked this week, last week. They've been fantastic, and the amount that how hard they worked at training. But yeah, we've already had a chat about how this is going to affect January's plan. So you spend months planning, and then this comes along again, and the financial implications of us having three games with no supporters, whilst everyone else can, albeit Cardiff in our league. Of course, it changes things a little bit. So you're always just having to pivot and spin and make sure you're ready for whatever comes next.
Excuse me. You said you'd had two cases, I think. Are they new? And are there any concerns with close contacts and players having to sit out as a result of that?
No. They had a few days off. Both were with their families. One was with his girlfriend the weekend, so I presume she'll isolate with him. But apart from that, they've not been together. So I think it's probably why they've avoided another case so far, which is a bonus for us and a positive for us. So we'll just have to wait and see what happens in the upcoming days and weeks. But pretty sure it'll affect us again at some point. Obviously, Millwall have been hugely affected by it. We're just hoping that they can get everyone back and get the game ahead. We want a game on Boxing Day. I'm sure our supporters will be travelling there, want a game as well. I think the focus is all on that now, all on that, and making sure we're on top of the players who are away, who are trying to keep fit as much as possible at home. As I said, both have not got any symptoms, which is a positive, which hopefully means they won't be affected too badly and they won't miss too long. And by the time they come back, they'll be in okay physical shape. And the rest is all we can control, really, is what we do here and how hard we work, and they're doing that brilliantly.
The issue of how many players in all British football are vaccinated or are getting vaccinated is right back at the top of the agenda again now. What's the situation at Swansea?
Well, both the guys who are positive have had one or both vaccinations. So is what it is. The outlook hasn't changed. We have a huge amount of players that have had both jabs. We have a couple who have already gone and got their booster jabs. Most of the staff are vaccinated and have had boosters. Some haven't. same with some of the players. All about choice, all about freedom of choice. Something that seems to be slowly being vilified or taken away. It's all about freedom of choice for the players. If they want to do it, they do it. If they don't, then that's their personal choice. So, that's where we're at, really. And we obviously had two players isolating recently who didn't have it because they were close contacts. Their kids had it. We just have to accept that's the situation. Certainly don't change my opinion on someone, whether they've had a vaccine or haven't. That's where I think there's a few clubs who have had everyone done. There's a few clubs who are struggling to get a lot of people done, but everyone's very different and everyone has their own opinion.
The UK sports minister said this week that there's a social responsibility involved in getting vaccinated. Jurgen Klopp, as I'm sure you've seen, has said he thinks it should be mandatory among footballers. What do you think?
I think footballers are some of the fittest and the healthiest young people in the country. We're close to a point in Britain right now where the people we were clapping a year ago, thousands upon thousands of them face losing their jobs because of a choice they have with their own body. So I'm not anti-vaccine, by the way, not at all, but I'm pro-choice, and I've said this to you before.
But the way the argument has moved on hasn't affected your view by the look of it, by the sound of it?
No, these are young men who have a choice in every other area of their life. And they make their decision based on the information they have, based on their experiences. That's it. I have to respect that. Totally respect that.
What about the logistical point of view, though, specifically for football squads, where we've seen games getting called off because players who aren't vaccinated have to isolate when a teammate gets COVID, which is, that's clearly an issue for managers, head coaches like yourself. Does that come into your thinking at all?
No, not at all. If we have to miss them because they've made a choice with their own body, then that's it. That's the risk they face of not being in the team, of being out of the team, losing their place in the team. That's their risk. Obviously, it's disappointing if we have to lose someone. But all goes back to, I'm not in control. No one is in control of what they want to put in their body. That's my view in it, whether you agree or disagree. I don't think it's ever happened before in my lifetime where we're told what you have to do. So they all have a choice. It's really that simple for me.
I will ask you a couple about football before I go.
Thank goodness for that.
Yeah, Millwall. I mean, you've had this little mini winter break almost, haven't you? Fixture-wise, anyway. Has that helped, do you think, going into the Millwall game?
I think it's been a real chance to analyse all of the work that we've done so far, where we're at, performances, results, what we feel we're really strong in, what we need to improve in. Going back to some real basic principles early on that formed the skeleton of what we were going to do, and then as things move on, we're trying to coach other things and different details, but then almost forgetting a few of the bits, the foundations that they were built on. So, yeah, going back to some of that, love how the players have worked the last week or so, over the last 2 weeks. Really excited to see them train this way. Obviously, a lot of meetings going on behind the scenes about January and the plans moving forward. And as I said, that will change, I'm sure, now in the next coming weeks. But, that's what energises us. That's what keeps us really positive and looking forward to what we can create here. Because we are, we're on the back of a few tough results, not performances. I think they've been pretty good on the whole, but we've paid for some individual mistakes and some really good finishing as well from the opposition. But when we look at it and step back from it and objectively take a look at it, we've created more chances in every game. We had the least shots against us in the last three games in the league. And the last five games in the league, and we've ended up losing three of them. We need to continue working hard. And if they continue the performance levels and we cut out some of the errors, we're going to be more than okay. And the way they're working this week suggests they're really ready and looking forward to the next game.
Yeah, and just on January, you've hinted at it a couple of times. The window's almost upon us. You've been saying for a while you've got plans in place. But is it fair to say that they are going to have to change because of the latest COVID regulations?
Yeah, I think the situation is really fluid, isn't it? We know the next three games at home, we have no one there. After that, who knows at the moment? That is affecting us already. There's no doubt about it. So, yeah, speaking to Julian, speaking to Mark, speaking to the owners, it'll be a case of seeing when those restrictions ease up, or if they get, you know, even if they get extended or whatever. So we'll just have to see. But it is, yeah, it's affected us already. How much, I'm not sure yet. That will take a bit more conversation, a bit more working out, I think, from the people back at the stadium who are brilliant. Once they work all that out, I'm pretty sure we will know what we have to work with. But the landscape's already changed. And yeah, I expect it to probably change again at some point.
Thanks a lot, Russell.
No problem.
Hi, Russell. How are you?
Hi, James. You okay?
Yeah, good. Thank you. On Monday, the EFL said that they're going to go forward with matches over the festive period. Do you think that's the right thing to do?
Yeah, I think if clubs have got enough fit players to play a football match, I think we need to do what we can to try and keep it going, really. When it stopped last time, I think I had so many messages of people who only really had the football to look forward to because of the amount of restrictions that were on, lockdown, etc. The impact it has on communities, on people's mental health. So I think for our players as well, for our players and staff and everything else, I think if teams can play, if they have enough fit players to play, then let's play. If at some point a game has to be called off and rearranged like we had last week, then that is the case. I'm not convinced, nothing suggests that a two-week circuit break or whatever has been suggested, we then don't come back into a similar situation. So, whilst we can keep playing, let's play. And if that ends up with us being without some key players for a game and other teams being it without, you know, that's, I think we all accept that's the situation for those of us who want to keep playing. The players definitely want to keep playing. And so we just have to deal with what comes in between that.